Ooh. Yeah, okay. Huh. Let's go! Yeah, the dopamine! Oh, that's the good shit, baby! Alright, looks like there's an upgrade to buy. Let me just go over here and I said go over here. Okay, it's gonna be one of these. It's okay. Not my first rodeo, no problem. How about a cheeky little Windows D? Oh god, he's clicking Ricardo. No, 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 stop, stop, stop. No, he's enjoying it. Stop, no! Okay, that was weird. Moving on. Okay, so what the fuck is a Clicker Heroes? If you've never been introduced to the world of idle games, then congratulations, you've lived a pretty fulfilling life. Let's put an end to that. Idle games are to normal games what sugar is to fruit, or what Ricardo is to my heart. That last one didn't really make any sense, but the sugar analogy was good. So imagine a role-playing game. You've got skills and levels and shit, and the more you play, the more your character levels up and gets stronger. Now imagine we take away all the skill, achievement, and rewarding gameplay required to get that level up, slap on some microtransactions, and whammy, you've got an idle game, baby. It's manipulative and borderline unethical, but fuck me if I don't love them. Okay, so this is Clicker Heroes, the basic gist is we've got our hero boys over here and our monster boys over there. To kill the monsters, you just click them. No pesky strategy or reflexes, just click a monster that isn't moving and can't fight back in any way. You can upgrade your heroes to give more damage each click, or if you think clicking on a stationary object is a little bit too challenging, then the heroes will even kill the monsters on their own. No clicking or playing the game at all required. So the plan is to take the only remaining gameplay, which is upgrading the heroes and stuff, and make an AI to do all that shit for us. Why? Okay, let's start out coding a safety net so we don't give Ricardo another click job. That is the worst sentence. So I started coding that, and then I got into a battle with an unknown text-to-speech entity.
Clicker heroes C:\. Confirm exit. Confirm exit. Clicker heroes C:\.
Who are you? Okay, coding done, and now if we freak the fuck out, the computer will recognize our pain and set us free. Perfect. I'm sure that won't break and go terribly wrong at some point. Okay, so now we got a mouse that clicks on a monster a bunch, but that's not really anything, and not nearly enough to extend this video to 10 minutes, so let's click some other shit. I'm talking heroes, I'm talking levels, I'm talking... that's pretty much it, really. It's not that hard a game. Or an exciting video. Okay, so first we need to progress to the next stage, because as fun as it is killing these guys over and over again, my dopamine levels are dropping, so let's actually progress in the game. Okay, so how are we gonna do this? We could constantly check if the next level is available by analyzing the pixels, then only clicking on the next level when it's available. The only problem is that's some nerd shit and I can't be fucked doing that. So instead, we're just gonna go with the Ape Man version. We're just gonna, like, click here sometimes. Yeah, that's it, baby. Let's go. level 13, but the monsters are taking a while to kill, which if I had to guess, probably has something to do with them having 200 times as much health as they did before. Just a guess, but once again, my dopamine has stopped a-flowing, so the coding needs to start a-going. Okay, that's it. So that was way less exciting than I thought it would be, but threat not, there's much more we can do. Apart from leveling up the heroes, we can buy upgrades for them. These upgrades are nuts. Most of them at least double the damage to the hero. I unfortunately decided to do some proper programming things like creating classes and doing some math and shit, but don't worry, all this code still pretty much amounts to... Also, I did manage to fuck up and upgrade the wrong hero, so you just ignore that. Okay, are you ready for the action?
Hole in one!
Okay, with those upgrades done, let's see how we go now. Oh wow, it lost to the boss immediately. Nice. This game sucks. Okay, so did I improve it? No. Did I go to bed? Fuck yeah, I did. So 8 hours of clicking later and we got some money! 160k, baby! Upgrades for days and it's gone. Well, gotta spend money to make money, so let's see how much further we get. Oh, that's it. Oh, we died to a boss. Oh, okay. That was quicker than I thought. How far did we get? Five stages? Cool. No doubt. Cool. Yeah, sure. That sucks. Fuck. All right. It would appear that the brute force strat of just going to bed a lot might not really be as effective as I thought it was gonna be. So unfortunately, we're gonna have to actually make this bitch smart. So the first problem is that if you just let our boy run, he's gonna get stuck on bosses. Bosses are big boys that you see every 5 levels, which you have to beat in under 30 seconds in order to continue. If you fail this, the timer resets and you start again. So if my boy gets to a boss and fails it, it'll just keep trying until the heat death of the universe, gaining no money and just wasting time. This isn't usually a problem because humans can, you know, think, but my boy ain't into that shit, so he just goes all Eye of the Tiger and never gives up. So in order to get over this mammoth of a problem, we are unfortunately gonna have to do something pretty revolutionary. We're gonna have to actually look at the screen. What the fuck? I know, sorry, fuck. It has to be done. Yeah, so far we've just been clicking on specific positions blindly and just hoping for the best, which is, you know, a strategy. Not what I'd call a good one, but you know, it's worked so far. So to see if we're currently bossing, we'll check for this little clock right here, which only shows up for boss fights. And this is actually pretty easy. All this involves looking at a specific pixel position and seeing if that pixel color matches the color of the
clock.
It's pretty basic shit. If that
clock
is showing for more than 30 seconds, that means we fucked it up and we're gonna need to grind for a bit. So it starts a timer, clicks on the previous level and hits the grind. We got still a lot of work to do, but not bad. A problem I'm seeing is that we aren't saving up for upgrades. At level 10, we unlock the first upgrade, but we can't afford it because we keep leveling up this bitch. Meaning we're waiting until the price of the upgrade is eclipsed by the price of leveling up the hero, which doesn't happen until level 22, which is a huge amount of wasted time. So in order to do this, we're gonna need to know when we have unlocked a new upgrade. So here's what I'm thinking. If we mouse over the upgrade, a pop-up will pop up with text saying that we don't have enough levels if we don't have enough levels. So plan A is we try using an AI which can read text from an image. I found a Python library called PyTesseract and just slapped that bitch in. Okay, buddy, how are you doing? What does this say? What do you reckon? What are we thinking?
A-Z-E. He. N shot. Bin. T. Atlik. Dollar Reen shot. Beer 00 E 0 U.
Okay, so plan B is instead of reading it, we can just look at this area and see if any red pixels are happening, which honestly feels like a much more Code Bullet branded idea. This more or less works, and that is good enough for me. I mean, it actually does fail in like 6 ways, but half of them are boring, and half of them I don't remember how or if I fixed them, so moving on. Okay, let's speed up for a bit, because we're fucking 10 minutes into a clicker game video. Okay, so we're gonna have to scroll down, because there'd be heroes down there. Does clicking this move the heroes up by a consistent amount of pixels? No, it's randomized, because fuck you. So, how did I do it? I clicked scroll once and counted how many pixels it moved. Does that work? Kind of. Does it take forever to scroll? You bet. What time is it? It's time for war. Let's explain this little shit. Trying to create an AI to play this game is not an original idea, so to speak. So the devs put in this little guy. When you see this guy, you're supposed to click him and you are rewarded with gold and gems. Gems being the premium currency used to buy valuable upgrades. Other than paying for them with real human money, this is the only way that you can get gems. So, we're gonna need to click him. Okay, it should be pretty easy, right? You just click him. Wrong, it always appears in a different position, size, and rotation. Okay, then we should just search for an orange pixel with the same RGB values as- Wrong, it's a little bit transparent, so the specific RGB values are always a bit different depending on what's behind it. Okay, then can't we just- Wrong, there are plenty of other shit on the screen with similar levels of orange. Alright, you don't have to be a dick about it. What? How are we gonna find it then? You simple fool, find it? You're not thinking like a bullet. Why work smarter when you can work harder? If we can't find out where to click, then we just click everywhere. Yes! Fuck you, you Nazi shit, we got ya! Outplayed, baby! Woo! So yeah, every 5 minutes or so, we just click pretty much everywhere. We just had to make sure not to click on anything important, like buttons or whatever, but apart from that, easy game, easy game. Okay, so moving forward, we did some more optimizations, then we broke everything, then I fixed it, then we broke everything. Then a new enemy approached. Right, time for some interactive content. Let's see if you can figure out what is wrong with this clip. So yeah, we lagging up a storm. It's like 10 minutes behind. It's not ideal, really. Especially because some of our checks require hovering over something and then seeing what happens. So yeah, that's bad. Just keeps getting better, huh? So I don't know if it's struggling with the excessive actions per second or if it's just being a bitch because I destroyed this little fish child. A better man than me would probably figure out what the problem was before finding a solution, but that's some pussy shit. Watch this. I know, we're lagging. What do we do? Wait for it. Wait for it. Just shut everything down, baby. Oh, hell yeah. Then, oh shit, we let the AI use the search bar. No way that can go wrong. And we're back. Just click on some other shit and whammy. The lag is gone. Fuck yeah, all we do is win. Also, just an aside, we have enough gems now by clicking on these little to buy an in-game auto clicker, which only clicks like 10 times a second, which is fucking lame, but every bit counts, so that's what that is. Even though our AI is about as consistent as my upload schedule, I think it's about time we let this bitch ride. So, you know it, you love it, it's time-lapse time, baby. So you're welcome for another beautiful time lapse. But we kind of got stuck here. We can't seem to get past this nasty boy at level 160. We could grind for ages and then get past him. But the main problem is we can't afford the next hero. He's sped as fuck. We only have like 10,000 O-dollars and we're going to need 10,000 U-dollars. So like, you know, need I say more? Yeah. Yeah, you do. What? Yes. Okay, rude. Okay. So if this is how much we have, then this is how much we're gonna need. I don't know, I just eyeballed these squares, but it's a billion times more money, which is a few. Anyway, what I'm trying to say is we need to do something to mix it up, and that something is Ascension. Ascension is this game saying, hey, you know that tedious as fuck level up process that you just sat through and hardly played? Yeah, let's do that whole fucking thing again, but this time it happens a little bit faster.
Starting again from scratch.
With the
slight increase in progression speed.
So, when we ascend, we get some hero souls, which can be used to upgrade some things called ancients that'll boost our stats and shit. The astute amongst you might have already noticed that during our previous time-lapse, we already had some hero souls. That's because I'm a professional YouTuber and forgot to record the first time I ran through an ascension. Instead, I did manage to record me buying some chicken. By themselves, each hero soul boosts your damage by 10%. So if we have 33 hero souls, that's now a 330% damage increase, which is very nice. So let's just run this bitch overnight and see how much progress we get. I did automate the ascension process. All you have to do is upgrade a certain hero. Potential epilepsy warning. These time lapses are getting long, so they're sped up like a bitch. It's flashy, it's colorful. So I think that might do the job. I don't really know what triggers them, but if that sounds like that's not your cup of tea, then yeah, probably fuck off. It's fine. It's a Clicker Heroes video. It's not a huge loss that you won't be able to finish this. Trust me. Okay, let's get into it. So I don't know if I've explained this yet, and I definitely should have, but I haven't. What we do is we just level up each hero until we have all the upgrades for that hero. Then we move on to the next one and then rinse repeat until we get stuck at Frostleaf. Then we keep upgrading Frostleaf until we get to a boss that we can't beat. Then we ascend, get a little more damage, do it all over again, and hopefully get further next time. Okay, so 10 hours of gameplay later, we've got soul for days. To my surprise, the program didn't break. Not from lack of trying, mind you. It even found a way into the shop at some point. Very concerning. A couple more clicks and I'd probably have to plug my Patreon. I think it was just browsing. It didn't actually buy anything. But whenever the AI got too confused, we just said hey-o to old Ricardo, did a cheeky reset. Anyway, now that we're rolling in hero souls, let's spend them on these bad boys. At this point, we're not really supposed to have this much. We're supposed to spend some of them pretty much immediately, not acquire however many we had. So we can buy quite a few. So let's assemble the squad. Yeah, most of them are just damage increases, but one of them is actually kind of interesting. It's the Juggernaut. Hey, stop, please. Anyway, the Juggernaut increases the damage based on how many clicks you've done in a row, and that's this counter up here. So when we're clicking at about 40 clicks a second, that number is gonna get big. But yeah, that's it. That's the squad we got. Now let's upgrade these boys and see how far we get this time. Go get it. The time lapse 48. okay, another time lapse, another 10 hours of my life, and holy shit, if you could see how much footage I'm having to sit through to edit this. Ugh, and I was like, hey, let's record everything in 4K so my computer can have a stroke whenever I want to edit literally anything. Fuck this game. Anyway, that be a good run. So we've gotten to level 500. We've unlocked the Dread Knight and we've got like 2,600 hero souls. We're probably pretty close to being done, right? Oh no. No, 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 no. That's right, you're gonna start again, you dumb bitch. No, no. Please, no, anything but that. Fuck that, you belong to me now, you little bitch boy. I'm not a little bitch boy. You're my little bitch boy, say it. I'm your little bitch boy. Now what do good little bitch boys do? We transcend. That's right, you start getting your whole shit. So, transcendence. It's like ascension, but like, again? So transcendence is like starting again. You lose all your ancients and you lose all your hero souls and you replace them with, you ready for it? Ancient souls, because that's fucking different. You can use these to level up things called outsiders, which are pretty much the same as ancients, but like a little better, I guess. I don't know, it's dumb. So yeah, I'm just gonna play the footage in the background while I talk, because I am so fucking over this game. Yeah, so I didn't actually have to change the AI that much, just a few things here and there. The number of hero souls you get after transcending is just ridiculous. The first ascension, we get like 15,000 hero souls, which is like 10 times more than after we had like 50 ascensions. From here, the game actually gets really boring. I know it was no groundbreaking achievement of entertainment before, but it's just like most of this is waiting for shit to respawn because you kill stuff immediately. So you just have to wait until you're at a high enough stage, then you transcend immediately. Turns out that automating the limited gameplay actually makes it considerably less fun. And I can probably talk about the specifics of what I did and why for about 3 hours, but I don't want to do that. And you probably don't want to hear that. But I mean, what you want isn't really part of this. So fuck it, let's just super fast forward until the end. Okay, so yeah, I passed level 1,000. That was nothing, it was just another boss. We got millions of hero souls, transcended again, got more hero souls, more ancient souls, unlocked a bunch of heroes, did some more stuff, I guess. Okay, I think we're done. I don't think I've been more apathetic about a project ever. So let's just call it that. What the fuck was that? Okay, sorry. I did actually enjoy the programming of this, but the editing of this shit sucks. I thought about going until I unlocked all the heroes and finishing the game, but turns out that would take like 6 months of running the program every night. So like, no. Anyway, fuck this game. It's garbage. Don't play it. I don't know why I thought this was a good idea for a video. Yeah, okay. Let's talk about the elephant in the room. I was gonna address it at the start, but I liked the intro I had. It's been a while. Hey, hi. Welcome back. I guess you should be welcoming me back, I guess. But yeah, anyway, my bad. I took a bit of a break. Most YouTubers tell their audience when they're doing that, but I guess I've just built a little different. At first, I did not intend on taking a break. I just like kept giving up on projects because they were all bullshit, like this one. I would have started probably at least 6 different projects, and if you can't tell, I was pretty close on giving up this one. But I thought I should just finish it so I can break the drought. I'll probably circle back and complete some of these projects I've started because they're like 60% done, so that should be easy content, right? But yeah, okay. I'm rambling, but the moral of the story, the TLDR is I'm back, baby. I've got some cool video ideas, which I will try to actually finish, which is that's a novel thought. But yeah, anyway. Bye. Later, losers. See you in hopefully less than a year. Not a high bar to hit, but who knows? Anyway, bye. Don't play Kicker Heroes. It's pretty bad. Okay, bye.